What is up, YouTube? Luca here with another PvE build for the Waking Flame DLC. This time with my stamina Nightblade. Like on my two previous PvE builds, I used Carve as extra dot. The bleed damage can stack up to 3 times now, and it's super super strong. It deals 8 to 9k DPS on dummy. You should definitely use it. Other than that, nothing has changed, the exact same setup, same rotation and same build like in the previous patch. I only passed like 30 minutes and managed to get 107k plus DPS. With a little bit more crit luck, should be go even higher with 108, 9 or maybe 110k DPS. Like I said before, rotation exactly the same. The only change is Carve, so keep up all 3 sticks until the end, even in execute, and yeah, then you're good to go. If you want to see the rotation explanation, I will link it in the description below, check it out. Now enjoy the pass, afterwards I'll show you the exact same setup like in the previous patch. Have fun. Here we are with the build. 5 Reliquin on the body, 1 Slime Core and the mythic item, Harpooner's Wading Kilt. Front bar, Advancing Yukida with a Great Axe. And back bar, the Black Rose, Perfected Daggers. Keep in mind, this setup is perfectly adjusted only for single target fights. If you can't keep up the Reliquin stacks or the Yukida stacks, like in raids like in Cloud Rest or Asylum, you should probably swap Reliquin for Perfected Yandere and Yukida for Kinras. Should be definitely better then. If you don't have access to mythic items in general, just use one Grundwolf and one Slime Core. Traits, full Divines, full Bloodthirsty on the Jewelry, still Precise on the front bar and double Infused on the back bar. Glyphs, full Max Stamina on the body, full Weapon Damage on the Jewelry, the double Dot Poisons on the front bar and back bar, a Poisoned and Flame Damage Enchant. Quick look on the skills. Like I said before, the only change is Carve, a super powerful dot ability now. I still don't have a clue why Zoss is constantly buffing weapon abilities. Previous patch Stampede, now Carve, instead of balancing out class abilities. But yeah, it's only my opinion, they should definitely keep a balance between weapon and class abilities. Second skill, Killer's Blade or Execute, which we use at 25%. Surprise Attack or Spammable. Relentless Focus for 10% more crit damage and for the powerful Bow Proc Assassin's Scourge. Stampede, another dot. Incap, which gives us 20% more damage for 6 seconds after we use it. Backbar, Rending Slashes. Deadly Cloak, Barb Trap, Twisting Path, still worth it, deals almost 4k DPS, Dark Shade, also worth it, even if it's a magic ability like Twisting Path, pretty nice for sustain 2 then. And again Incap for extra crit rate on the back bar. Race, Danmo. I didn't test Kajito, probably similar, maybe even better with more crit luck. Mundustone, the Thief for extra crit rate. Lava Food Soup, Esper Food. In raids, I recommend to use the green max stamina food. 64 points in stamina. Potions, same like always, with stamina, brutality and savagery. CPs, blue ones. Fighting Finesse, Backstabber, Deadly Aim and Master at Arms. If you can't flank the enemy, just swap Backstabber for Thaumaturge or maybe even Wrathful Strikes here. Recipes, Boundless Vitality, Rejuvenation, Fortified and Sustained by Suffering the new recipe. If you don't have sustain issues, you can change this one for Bastion to deal more damage against shielded targets. That's it with another PvE build, only small adjustments this time. Maybe next patch they will change some class abilities, we will see. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, don't forget to sub my channel, and I wish you all a wonderful day. See ya guys.